Okay, guys, Not Nuts here. Welcome back. Hopefully this is the third part of a three-part series for the Stormdrane paracord woven and half-hitched paracord pouch. And we've got our little can here pretty much done. I'm going to show you guys some stuff I've done there. And hopefully we'll do the third part here in a minute. I'm going to reiterate once again, please leave comments down below for improvements, suggestions, stuff you like, stuff you didn't like or dislike, and please subscribe. Click that button wherever it is. I'm not sure. Click that button. Okay, so we're going to get started here right away. So I've gotten maybe 80% around the can with the vertical weaving, and I've gotten to right about here. I've removed all the sticks from it, as you can see, and this is really tight around the can. If I put any more vertical rows in here, this thing is going to start to squish the can, which is going to deform the work that I'm doing, so we got to find something else to complete this on. I'm just looking for stuff that I have right here, right at hand, and first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the camera so you guys can see what I'm doing now. I'm just going to slide this work off of here, off of the can. I'm going to take all the stuff that I've taped down loose first, and then I'm just going to slide the whole thing right off the end of the can. Twisting motion seems to help. And before I go any further, I'm going to stick a Dr. Pepper can in there just to see, get an idea of if we're going to be close or not to the diameter of a Dr. Pepper can. Right now it looks like I've got quite a bit of slack in there. If I turn it this way, you can probably see better. See, I've got, it looks like it's going to be quite a bit. But when I finish this, that some of that will tighten up. It may be a little floppy on the can, but I think it'll be good enough that we can work with it. So, for now, I'm just going to use this hairspray can, which is quite a bit smaller than a Dr. Pepper can, diameter-wise. But it's just going to be something that we can kind of use to keep our work in place and finish this. So I'm going to pinch it in back like this. And then I can just finish my weaving in here. And then when I get done with that, I'll come back and show you how to finish it off with the, finish the ends and do the vertical half hitching and add a drawstring at the top. Okay guys, I've got my vertical weave completed all the way around, as you can see, and I fit a can in there, and a Dr. Pepper can just fits through there smooth with no slack, but it's also not tight. It's just real easy. If I hold it gently, that can will fall right out, and if I just kind of put a little bit of pressure on it, the can will not fall out. So I'm pretty happy with that. I would have liked it to be a little bit more snug, but I'm fine with it. So the next part is to finish off a lot of these ends and make a decision, since I'm using two colors, what color I want the bottom half hitching to be. I've got a lot of black left over and tan. I'm probably going to do it with tan so that you guys, it'd be easier for you guys to see what I'm doing here. But I think if it was me, I'd prefer to have it all black. But so the next step is to finish off these and then make a decision. So I'm probably going to cut this black off with about 2 inches of length and then start working my half hitching. However, this is a good point right here to finish off the other ends that you have. And if it's one piece of cord, if you're using one continuous piece of cord, it's only going to be one end, and you can do that later. If you're using one continuous piece of cord instead of two pieces like I'm doing on this project, Stormdrane, on his instructions, if you start at the top, he wants you to finish it on the bottom so that your slack is running off the bottom, and then you do your half hitching around the bottom. I like them to both finish on the top. So if you start it on the top, I like for the slack to end up on the top like this is. And then finish off, tie one end down inside, and then just start working it that way. But you can do it however you like, and if you don't like it, make another one and make improvements. So my next step here is I'm going to turn this entire project inside out and sew down the ends that I'm not going to use. So you want all your finished ends to be finished off on the inside of the pouch so that they're not showing. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take like this black end that's right here. I'm going to cut it maybe so that it's about 2 inches long, about that long, and then I'm going to fold it down along the inside, and then I'm going to take some, after I cut it, of course, I'm going to singe the end, and then I'm just going to sew it right to that, another black, or to this tan cord here, this tan vertical cord, and it'll be done. And I'm going to do the same thing with this loose tan cord. I'm going to fold it down and then sew it down, and then this other black end, so that I only have one long working end to do half hitching with. And when I'm done sewing those down, I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, I'm back, and I wanted to show you the stuff I've sewn down. I don't know if you can see this, but this is one of the black ends that I've sewn down on the inside. Tan end is much more visible, and here's another black end that I've sewn down. This is my working coyote tan end that I'm going to use to do my half hitching here in a minute. There's nothing fancy or special. It's just sewn down like two or three stitches here, two or three stitches here, two or three stitches here, and two or three stitches here to keep it from moving around, and that's all there is to it. I'm sorry I can't go into more detail than that. The lighting here is so bad I had to go over by the window to see what I was doing. I was starting to go flipping blind from trying to do it over here by the camera. So if you guys wanted to quick tutorial sometime on how to sew that down, leave a comment and I'll get back to you. Okay, so turn your project right side out again so all the sewn down ends are on the inside where nobody will probably ever even know they're there. The working end of the cord needs to be at the bottom of the can. Put your Dr. Pepper can or whatever you're going to be using this for, or whatever form that you want to use to finish this half hitching, but you're going to need this to be around something to act as kind of a form while you're tying this. And it's time to start the half hitching. You'll notice here, this half hitching is what took me the longest time to figure out. You'll notice that I have a loop here. This is from the vertical hand, and this is the horizontal. I'm going to do a half hitch on this, 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 this. So there'll be a half hitch on tan, black, tan, black, tan, black, all the way around for the first row. Okay, and then I'll come back and then I'll show you what that looks like. And you want to start and go, if you're looking at the bottom of the can, you're wanting this to go, this is coming out on an end here, so I'm going to start it off on a loop, a vertical loop, and go up through, pull your slack out. I'm going to try and show you guys this. I'm going to point this at you. This is going to be backwards for me, but the point is for you guys to be able to see what's going on. So up through, and then down. And your first half hitch is going to look kind of weird. That's okay. And then pull it. You want to tie it so that it's snug, but not pulling on the work. So I just did a tan one. Now I'm going to do a black one. So it's up through the black, and then pull your cord through. Get the twists out. See how I'm untwisting it to get the twists out. There you go. And then I've got a little loop here, and this is what I'm going to go back down through here in a second. But I want to show you the tension that you want to get. So I'm putting this much tension, and that's just right. If I put this much tension to where I'm pulling on the work, that's too much. And if I have this much so that there's a loop here at the bottom, that's too loose. So pull it just so that there's no hole that you can see through, but it's not pulling on the work like that. Okay, so I just came up with it. Now I'm going to go down with it. So go back down through the thing that you just made. Pull everything through. Get all the twists out. And then the next one is going to be on a tan one. So up, some of these twists out by straightening out your paracord from time to time. I'll show you how to do that here in a second. And then just pull it snug, and then down through the loop that you just made. Pull it through. This is really getting tangled. Down through. Actually, as I'm pulling it, I'm twisting it. See? That gets the twist out. You might want to pull it a little snug here, and then pull it down through. Okay, so then to get this paracord here is snug or is twisted. So to get it untwisted, just pull, grasp it between two fingers, and kind of pull it all the way out to the end, and that'll help untwist it till you get to your working end, and then go back to work. All right, so it's up through. Sew through, see how that came out without any twists in it, and then down through. So now I'm going to pull the tension, and then I'm going to pull the working end through. I just was on a black, now I'm going to do tan, so pull it up. Twist that one a little bit. Every time you do this, it twists a little bit more until you get to the point where you're going to have to untwist it again or just work with it. So now I'm going to pull that snug and then down through. Can you see my half hitching that we're starting to make there? Looks pretty good. Looks pretty even. Trying to get the tension even and consistent throughout the whole project all the way through. Alright, so now I've done a knot on every tan and alternating tan and black loop all the way around. And if you look at that, it looks pretty symmetrical. Not too bad, not too shabby. Now we're going to do another loop, still continuing around clockwise. But you'll see that these loops here on the end are what we're going to tie our half hitching to. See, the ones that we just made. And they're not a lot of space in there, so I'm going to tie on every other one. I'm going to tie on the first one right now. This will be the first loop right here. And that's going to make it have a little bit of a gap in the loops that are on the bottom of the half hitching work, and you'll see that here in just a second. Okay, so, well, let me tie one more. So, I just tied the first one on this one. I'm going to skip this one and go to the second one. See, there's kind of a little hole there, if you can see that. And I'm going to tie this through. Just like before, don't pull it to where it's pulling your knot out of shape, but just get it good tension on it, and then pull your guy through. Now, see, this is what I'm talking about. This row through, since I'm doing every other one, is going to leave a bit of a bigger gap here than it did on the previous row, which right here is almost no gap. See that? Pretty big size gap right here, and almost no gap. So I'm going to continue this around, and you'll be able to see more closely what I'm talking about when I've gone. Okay, so now you can see here's my working end. I'm just going to hold it up out of the way for a second. You can see I've done my second go-around, and you can tell, if you remember how small the gaps were on this previous row, this one has pretty sizable gaps in each one. So instead of skipping every other one, this time I'm going to tie a knot in each one, since there's a big gap there to tie a knot through. And then when I tie that row, there's probably going to be a tight space, and so I'm going to skip another one, and so on. And that's how you do it, to make it come out looking pretty even. That looks pretty symmetrical right there. I'm pretty happy with that so far. So and that's good, because I'm starting to run out of my working end, so that's good. So, and we're continuing the up through.